Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a Rosa hair products update. I've had this hair in for 3 months. This is the Malaysian straight hair. And if you guys haven't seen my 1 month review, I will link it somewhere in this general vicinity so you guys can see that, what I was thinking of it at 1 month, and then come on back to this video and see what I'm thinking of it now. But if you guys are all ready to find out what I think of this hair after 3 months of wear, then just stay tuned. Okay guys, so first off, I'm gonna say it, I am that jerk who wears a black t-shirt in a hair video. I know, I'm tired, it's been a long day. I've been up since 6:30 in the morning and it is 7:30 at night and I feel like a grandma, like I'm about to crawl in bed. I had college orientation this morning, got to sign up for my classes and stuff, so yeah, I'm tired. Excuse me. But we are talking about this hair today. Yes, guys, it is my Rosa Hair Products Malaysian straight hair, and I have in the length 18 and 16 inch, and I have in 4.5 bundles and a 16 inch closure. I really can't give you the exact specs of how many of each bundle I have in. I think it's like 2.5 of an 18 and then half of a 16, or 2 of a 16, so it makes up 4.5, I believe is how I have it in, but don't quote me on that, I can't remember. It's in my 1 month video, but anywho, first things first, I'm going to answer some of my frequently asked questions about this hair, and one of the main ones I get is, does it hold a curl? Yes guys, it holds a curl. These are 3 day old curls. I don't curl this hair every day because it really truly holds a curl. Now I will say part of it is my upkeep of this hair. As you guys know, I use this Davines spray, the no gas curling spray, basically just preps the hair to be held for a curl, and then I use hairspray. So those two items do, I would say, extend the life, but regardless, this hair really does hold a curl. I also find that the hair holds a curl better when it's clean. So usually I wash my hair once a week and I'll only curl it twice in that 1 week. I might do a touch-up piece by my face here and there, but for the most part, I only curl it twice in that 1 week because after that, the hair starts to get a little bit of a product-y buildup and I need to wash it again to get quality curls. The next frequently asked question I get is, does the hair shed or mat? No, it does neither. I mean, check this hair out, guys, and I just sleep with it in like a bun. I have like a tingle right back here. There goes my first tingle. Yeah, it doesn't tingle much, nothing crazy going on. The hair really doesn't have bad tingling, shedding, anything like that. I'm coming up on wash day, so I'm getting a little bit more tangles than I normally what I would say, but other than that, no, the hair does not tangle or shed. The only time you guys are going to get a bit of tangling, like you guys are seeing me getting now, which isn't, I mean, it's not much at all, is when you're close to wash day. And that's because this hair just doesn't do good with having like product in it. Some hair types really do, like they thrive when they have a lot of product in them. I noticed that with curly hair, it does really good, just looks good, does better when the hair is a bit dirtier, so you can go like a week and a half or 2 weeks, you know, without washing your hair. But this particular Malaysian straight hair does need to be washed once a week if you want the best looking hair and the most bang for your buck, I would say, because there's nothing wrong with this hair. I could still rock this hair as much as I want. I'm just tired of having shorter hair, because as you guys can tell, I cut it even shorter, so it's not 18 anymore, it's 16, and that's just because I had lightened the hair too many times and the ends were just starting to look a little frazzled and brittle, so I cut them about a month ago and dyed the hair all back black. But you know, that was my bad. I bleached the hair like 5 times, so I mean, and it was only like the last couple, like inch and a half of the hair that needed to be cut. So that's pretty good for 5 bleachings and the hair to still be kicking and rocking with me. I have no complaints. But because of that, I am kind of tired of the shorter hair. I tried to give it a chance and rock it. And I know to some people, this is not short hair, this is long hair. But for me, this is short hair because y'all know, you have been watching my channel, my hair is usually at least a 22 inch. So, you know, this was a big change for me to do the shorter hair. I'm happy I did it, but I'm definitely excited to get back to my long hair. It's being shipped as we speak. Like, I'm tracking the package. So I'm so excited to get it, and you guys will be the first people to see me unbox it, of course. But on to my next frequently asked question. Everybody wants to see this closure up close, so I'm going to give you guys an up close and personal view.
Okay, this is the closure. I don't think I'm the best at putting on a closure at all, you guys, honestly. And I have a lot of weird, funky growth patterns in my baby hair. But the closure is really nice. Like, really, really nice. Doesn't have any, like, flyaway, crazy baby hairs. And it's a three-way parting closure. So, yeah. That's my closure. The knots came bleach. And all I do is put a little eyeshadow some days. And that's about it. But anyways, yeah. So, that's what the hair is looking like. I'm also going to show you the ends, which you guys can see they look fan-frickin-tastic. I mean, seriously, look at this hair. That shine, beautiful. It's not super high luster, it's like medium luster. Just gorgeous hair. So yes, I am loving this hair. I think it's honestly so stunning, so gorgeous, and I always get tons of compliments on it. Everyone's always like, I thought that was your real hair. No, it's not. No, it's not. But it does just look really good. Of course, another question I get asked all the time is, would I repurchase this? Obviously, yes, because I already repurchased from them and my new hair is coming in the mail. I'm not going to repurchase Malaysian hair because when I tried to leave some of my edges out with this hair, it just never could blend. And that's because I have edges that are transitioning from relaxed to natural. So I've got like a bit left of relaxed hair that I am kind of holding out on cutting because it's a good like 3-4 inches of my hair left, and it just doesn't blend right. Like, my natural hair does not blend with the Malaysian hair, but my relaxed hair does at the ends, and it just looks kind of busted and crooked and wrong. So because of that, I don't leave my edges out and stuff, and that's the only reason why I didn't repurchase Malaysian. Instead, I purchased Brazilian with a little bit of a wave to it so that I could kind of match my natural hair. But other than that, I just wanted to give you guys this review because I know I kind of went mute mode on it after I gave you guys a month update, but you always saw it in my videos, especially after October when I went through that weird patch where I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do with my hair. But, you know, of course I had to come back to my Rosa hair because it's just too fabulous and too nice and keeps my natural hair super well protected. But of course, if you guys have any questions, leave them down below. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And I'll leave you guys a link to a very similar makeup tutorial somewhere around here. I hope you guys are doing well out there. And I was going to say something and I forgot. Okay, whatever. Bye!